We have earlier seen how to add high quality images within our eBooks. In this video, we will learn the link between images and the royalties we earn. File size is one of the important factors when you publish an eBook. That's important also for how the royalties are also calculated. You may already be aware that Amazon KDP offers two types of royalty plans, the 35% royalty plan and the 70% royalty plan. Anyone who publishes on Amazon KDP can choose the default 35% royalty plan. In case you want to earn more and reach more readers, you could opt in for the 70% royalty plan, except that for some marketplaces such as Brazil, India, Japan and Mexico, you must also opt in to KDP Select if you want to go for the 70% royalty plan. So when you choose this 70% royalty plan, there is one more factor that gets included into the royalty calculation, and that is delivery fees. The 70% royalty plan has delivery fees based on the file size of the Kindle ebook. The 35% royalty plan does not charge any delivery fees. So let's now see how do they calculate the delivery fees. This is where the ebook's file size is taken into account. So in case your ebook file size is high and heavy, like say 100 megabytes or 50 megabytes, then it also means your delivery fees will also be high. On the other hand, if your ebook's file size is say 10 KB or 100 kilobytes or 1 megabyte, then your delivery fees will also be comparatively lesser. That's why it's a good practice to keep your ebook's file size lower to the extent possible. If you think, why does the ebook's file size increase? Then images seem to be the most known culprit. As you know, there are four main formats when it comes to images. They are JPEG, GIF, bitmap and PNG. KDP supports bitmap and PNG, while the Kindle book format accepts only JPEG and GIF formats. This could confuse us a little. So which format is best to use in our ebooks? If you had used bitmap or PNG within your Word document draft book while uploading to KDP, these tend to be usually on the heavier image formats because of the clarity it offers at pixel levels. That's why we convert those into JPEG files and thus get lesser image file size. We will see how to convert bitmap to JPEG in a few minutes, but before that, let's first understand that to reduce your ebook file size, you would need to first convert all your existing bitmap and PNG images to either JPEG or GIF formats. Then reinsert them into your ebook before re-uploading the ebook to KDP. This way you could potentially reduce the delivery fees and ultimately increase your royalties too. Let's now see how KDP calculates royalties. With the 35% royalty plan, the applicable VAT is first deducted from your ebook's list price. The resultant amount is then multiplied by the 35% royalty rate. This is the amount you will receive under the 35% plan. Now, the 70% royalty plan is also calculated in a similar way, except that the delivery fees gets included in the equation now. The VAT and the delivery fees both are deducted from your list price, and then that resultant amount is multiplied by 70% royalty rate to obtain your royalty amount. When calculating delivery costs, KDP will round the cost up to two decimal places for all the currencies except Japanese yen. That's just for information. All said and done, it's really hard to perfectly calculate the royalty we receive this way because these differ for every country and marketplaces. And also because these are ebooks, and they could be sold anywhere around the world, and every country has their own VAT calculations. That's why all of these calculations are programmatically automated into the KDP system. You could see some reports on the KDP accounts reports page to get an estimate of all your royalty earnings and calculations. Once you start earning more, then you may get closer to estimating your royalty earning patterns. Moreover, if you choose to go for the paperback options, or have already published few paperbacks through KDP, although it's not available for the Indian marketplace, KDP provides you with a royalty calculator to get at your own estimates based on the sales you make. I'll provide a link for that calculator in the description below. Let's now see how this image conversion is done. You could convert the bitmap to JPEG using Microsoft Paint itself. just open the bitmap file using MS Paint, then go to the File menu and choose Save As. Then change the file type to JPEG and save the file. You could then insert this JPEG file into your Word document manuscript file or the EPUB HTML file. You can now see the difference in the sizes. The bitmap file will be larger when compared with the JPEG file size. In case you don't use MS Paint software or don't use Windows computer altogether, you could also get these conversions done online using some free web services. There are even some free mobile apps that does this job for you. I'll provide all the download links in the description below. To conclude, when a lot of images are inserted into your ebook, the ebook's file size could drastically increase too, because that's directly proportionate. So by including JPEG files instead of bitmap, you could definitely reduce your overall ebook's file size, which means more royalties for you. But there is a side effect to this, which is losing out on the clarity of your images for all the inserted images. For that, just watch my earlier video on how to effectively replace your older JPEG files with uncompressed JPEG files. This will not only improve the image clarity, but also let you keep the lighter ebook file in terms of its overall size. I hope this video helped you in some way. If so, please support my work by either downloading my book and by leaving a positive review for my work on Amazon. You could also become a Patreon and support me that way, which will surely help me create more free videos and tutorials like this one that you are watching now. I'll see you again in another video. Until then, please take care. I hope this video helped draft books well and more for to reduce your ebook file size. You would need